So in this tutorial, let's see how to add your branch name, git branch name, on to show on your alongside your repo name in your terminal, bash terminal. Actually, you can use this procedure in any of your bash terminal or in any of the operating systems, or Linux, Ubuntu and macOS and so on. So let's see how to do this. So instead of writing our own script to do this, Git has already written us a script for our purpose. So we have this script hosted here. So I will share the link with you to this location. Here, so you can go to this location and then you can click on raw to download this one, and you can control S to save it to your favorite location, and then you can follow along this command. So let's see how to do this one. First, you have to source this file. So first of all, I will go to the, you can see this is a repo with this is a git repo. So I am in the master branch, so branch is not shown at the moment. So we'll go to our bash rc file. So and then the location we have to change is ps1. So let's search for ps1 here. You can use your favorite editor to open this file. So I have used Vim, so you can use anything. And then you can see if color. So let me bring this up and then I can zoom it in. So you can see if color prompt is yes, okay, this is executed, and if it is no, this is executed. We can modify both of them, or mostly this is executed, so we'll modify this one. So first I will, instead of directly modifying the bash rc file, let's try this outside first and then apply it here. So let me first copy this to my clipboard, and then I will get myself a text. So I'll open up a text editor and then I will paste it here, and then I will remove this space here. So you can see here. So I will copy. So before doing that one, before I paste this to my terminal, I copied it here to remove the space at the beginning, and then I will quit Vim. Then I will first source that git-prompt.sh. So I think I saved it in my program repo. Then I have it as git-prompt.sh. I will source that one. Then I will copy this one and paste it here. So there is no change. So I can. So what you see here is you have this. What is within this grab bracket is the. I think I did a mistake. So let's see. So what you see here within this square bracket is the color of the text. So you attach the username and the hostname like this here. So the color of it is green, and then the color, the colon's color, this colon has a color. It's no white, no color. And then this directory name has a color, and this dollar sign has no color. So to understand this, you can refer this this location. I will show you. So this how to geek this tutorial is very interesting to understand that how PS1 works. So here they have mentioned how each of them work. You can have a read through, and then here they have mentioned about the colors. So these are the colors, numbers for the color, and it the color start with this 0, 3, 3 and a starting square bracket, and these are the colors. You can experiment with them. And then this is one is for bold. So here we have a one. So yeah, we have one here. So that is for bold. So well, that's what we have here. One for bold to make this directory bold. So we are going to add the branch name to our PS1. To do this one, they have mentioned how to do this. So we need this part. We need to copy this part, and then we can edit to our git prompt. So this is the color for this dollar sign. So we have to add before the dollar sign. So that will be this location. So I will edit here. And then we need to provide a color for this git prompt. We don't want it to be blue, so we'll copy the color for something went wrong. So I don't want that. Is it? No. Okay. So there should be, I think. Okay. This one, let's hope. So I'll copy this one here, and then I will paste it there. So that will be blue. So what color I want it to be, say, yellow. So I like yellow. Yellow to be my branch name. So I send it to 33. So that's fine. So we have sourced this one. We copied that git prompt command from the sh file, and then we have set the color. So let's see how if it works. So I'll press enter. So you can see my master is shown here in the bracket. What I can do now is, I will change the color and see. So I will change the color to purple. 35 would be purple. So that will be 35. So I can change the color. So I need it to be blue or red, yellow. So I will copy this command here. Now we have got that to working. So I will open the git prompt, so bsh file. So then I'll go to the PS1, and then here I'll move it up. This is the location, and then I will first comment this out. So just in case if we want to remove it in the future or check it, I will comment it out, and then I will add the new command here. So you can see this command here. So I added this one. Now I have commented the other one. Now one more thing, I need to source the file. So I have to source the file here. So I will source the file here. So my location where I saved it. That should do it. So I will run the, I can source the bsh file to see if it works. So you can log in and log out and log in again to make this change permanent. For this is now temporary because we just sourced the bsh file. But once you log in and log out, this will be permanent. So you can reopen the terminal. So I can also, just to show you, I reopen the terminal also. So I will open the terminal. So I have the terminal here. I will go to that location where I have this my git repo, so I can see that the my master is turned yellow. You can log in and log out. Also maybe it's because of a change I did earlier, but you can log in and log out, and then you can or you can source the bash RC to send cheese the same result. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe for more videos.